Hello friends, welcome to the session on microprocessors. In this session, we'll be discussing about 8085 data transfer instructions. In this session, we will see what we mean by data transfer instruction, what are the different instructions that are being used to transfer the data between registers and memory locations. We will see how to write these instructions and what happens when these instructions are executed. Friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, and do subscribe to the channel to see many videos on the various topics of electronics and computer science. So let us start the session with the question, what we mean by data transfer instruction. We know that 8085 or 8085 is a microprocessor, and this is the simplest type of the microprocessor. This microprocessor can be used to build a microprocessor based system, and by using this microprocessor it is possible that we can achieve many functions. Whenever we want to use the microprocessor in certain application, then it is necessary that we must feed the instruction to the microprocessor. An instruction is a kind of a binary pattern that is being designed to perform a specific function or specific task. 8085 or 8085 has a lot many instructions. Say, for example, we can have about 246 different instructions available for the microprocessor 8085. These instructions can be classified into different categories, such as data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions, branching instructions, and control instructions. Now, in this session, we will discuss what we mean by the data transfer instructions. Data transfer instructions are those instructions that move the data between the registers of the microprocessor, or it is also possible that you can move the data between the registers and memory locations. In data transfer instruction, the content of the source is being copied into the destination, while the source content will remain as it is. And therefore, many times these instructions are also called as copy instructions. Data transfer instructions do not have any effect on the flags of the microprocessor 8085. So it is important that these instructions do not have any impact on the carry flag or sign flag or zero flag. And there are different data transfer instructions. So for example, we have an instruction such as move, where we can move the content from one register to another register or from register to memory location. We have the instructions such as move immediate, where the immediate data that is being available can be moved to the register. We have an instruction such as load accumulator, where we can load the contents of the memory location into accumulator. We have the instructions such as store accumulator, where the content of the accumulator can be stored into the memory location. It is also possible that you can make the use of the instructions such as LHLD, where H and L registers can be loaded directly from the memory. It is also possible that the contents of H and L can be stored into the memory. So there are different instructions that are being available in order to transfer the data. And many times, whenever we write any program for this microprocessor 8085, then while writing the program, frequently we need to transfer the data from one register to another register or from memory location to the register. And therefore, these instructions are very much required for writing assembly language programs for the microprocessor 8085. So now let us understand these instructions. The first instruction is the move instruction. The instruction move has a format such as the word MOV followed by the registers R1, R2. So this instruction is being called as a move register. where the contents of the register R2 are being moved to the register R1. And the addressing that is being used in this instruction is the register addressing. So the contents of the register R2 are being moved to the R1, and R1 and R2 are the registers that can be the registers such as A, B, C, D, E, H, and L. So we know that the 8085 microprocessor has a certain set of registers, out of which these registers can be used in this instruction. This is a 1-byte instruction. For example, whenever we write the instruction such as move A comma B, then the content of the B are being moved to the accumulator, that is A. Another form of this instruction is move R comma M, where we can move the contents from memory to the register. So the memory address is being stored in the HL pair, and the HL pair will point to the memory location, and the content of the memory location will be moved to the register. So this is an instruction which makes the use of the register in direct addressing. This instruction is also 1-byte instruction, that is only one opcode will be required for this instruction. The content of the memory location whose address is in the register pair H and L will be moved to the register R. And the register R can be one of these registers such as A, B, C, D, E, H, and L. For example, whenever we write the instructions such as move B, comma M, then the content of the memory pointed by the HL pair is being moved to the register B. Another form of this move instruction is move M, comma R, where we can move the content of the register to the memory. So in this case, the content of the register are moved to the memory of which the address is stored in the HL pair. So the addressing that is being used in this instruction is the register indirect addressing. This instruction is also 1-byte instruction, and the content of the register R is being moved to the memory location whose address is being pointed by the HL pair. So the register R that can be used in this instruction is A, B, C, D, E, H, and L. For example, when we write the instruction such as move M, comma C, then the content of the register C are being moved to the memory, which is being pointed by the HL pair. Another most commonly used data transfer instruction is the move immediate. So in the move immediate, the format is initially you have to write down this word MVI followed by R comma data. So in this case, the byte 2 of the instruction is being moved to the register R. So in this case, you will find that the data itself is being mentioned and the data has to be moved to the register R. So such type of the addressing is being called as an immediate addressing. So the content of the byte 2, that is the data of the instruction, is being moved to the register R. So this is an instruction which requires 2 bytes. So for example, when we write the instruction such as MVI A, A2H, then the data, which is the hexadecimal data 82, is being moved to the accumulator. So H in the H, 82H will indicate that this number is a hexadecimal number. Another type of the instruction that is being used is the move immediate M, data, where we are moving the data to the memory. So the content of the instruction, that is the byte 2, is being moved to the location which is being pointed by the HL pair. So the addressing that is being used is the immediate and register indirect addressing. So the content of the byte 2 of the instruction is being moved to the memory location whose address is in registers H and L. So this instruction is also a 2-byte instruction, since the data itself is appearing in the instruction, and therefore these instructions are 2-byte instructions. So for example, when we write the instruction such as MVI M, 12H, then the data 12, which is the hexadecimal data, is being moved to the memory location, which is being pointed by the HL pair. Another type of the instruction that is being used is LXI, where the format of the LXI is LXI RP, 16-bit data. Now this instruction is being called as a load register pair immediate. That is, the data that is being available in the instruction itself is being moved to the register pair. So this instruction is a 3-byte instruction, where the byte 3 is being moved to the higher order register and the byte 2 is being moved to the lower order register. The addressing that is being used in this instruction is the immediate addressing. So byte 3 of the instruction is being moved to the higher order register RH of the register pair RP, and byte 2 of the instruction is being moved to the lower order register RL of the register pair RP. And as I said, this is a 3-byte instruction. Now the register pair that can be used with this instruction can be BC, DE, HL or SP. Now RH is the first register in the register pair and RL is the second register in the register pair. So for example, when we write the instructions such as LXI HL, 4000H, then the 40 is being moved to the register H and 00 is being moved to the register L. Another instruction that is being commonly used is the load accumulator and store accumulator. So frequently, whenever we write any assembly language program and when the result is computed in the accumulator, then that result has to be stored somewhere. And or whenever we want to move the data to the accumulator, then in that case, we can make the use of these instructions. So load accumulator address is the load accumulator direct instruction, where the address is mentioned in the byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction itself. So the content of the memory location whose address is specified in the byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction is being moved to the accumulator. So this is a 3-byte instruction because the address itself appears in the instruction. So for example, when we write the instructions such as LDAC000H, then the content of the memory location C000 is being moved to the accumulator. So whenever you want to move the data from memory location directly into the accumulator, then in that case, you can make the use of this instruction. And whenever you compute any result in the accumulator and you want to store this result in some memory location, then you can make the use of the STA address or store accumulator direct instruction. This is also a 3-byte instruction where the content of the accumulator are moved to the address specified in the instruction. So this is a direct addressing instruction. So the content of the accumulator is being moved to the memory location whose address is specified in the byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction. So for example, when we write the instructions such as store accumulator D000H, then the contents of the accumulator are moved to the memory location D000. So these instructions are very useful and frequently we need to make the use of these instructions while writing the assembly language programs for 8085. Another set of instruction is the LHLD and SHLD, where LHLD is followed by an address, that is load H and L direct. That is the content of the location pointed by the byte 2 and byte 3 is being moved to the register L, and the content of the location pointed by the byte 2, byte 3 plus 1 is being moved to the register H. So this is a 3-byte instruction where the content of the memory location whose address is being specified in the byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction is moved to the register L, and the content of the next memory location is being moved to the register H. So for example, when we write the instructions such as LHLD 2100H, then The content of 2100 are moved to the register L and 2101 are moved to the register H. Another instruction that is being used is the store H and L direct, and its format is SHLD followed by an address, where the content of L are moved to the byte 3 and byte 2 locations, and the content of H are moved to the next location. So the addressing used is the direct addressing, because the address is directly specified in the instruction. So the content of L is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in the byte 2 and 3, and the content of H, register H, is being moved to the succeeding memory location, that is the next memory location. So for example, when we write the instruction such as SHL3520, then you will find that the content of the L will be moved to this location 3520, and the content of H will be moved to the location 3521. Now, let us understand another data transfer instructions. And these instructions are LDAX, STX, and exchange. LDAX is the load accumulator indirect instruction, and its format is LDAX-RP, where the content of the register pair RP is being moved to the accumulator. So this instruction makes the use of register indirect. So the content of the memory location whose address is in the register pair RP is being moved to the register A. RP can be either BC, that is B, or it can be D, that is DE. This is a one byte instruction, since the address is not there, and therefore this is one byte instruction. So for example, when we write the instruction LDAXB, then you will find that the content of the location that is being pointed by the register pair BC is being moved to the accumulator. Now, it is also possible that we can store the content of the accumulator indirectly by using STXRP, where the content of the accumulator are being moved to the location that is being pointed by the register pair. So this register also makes the use of addressing register indirect. So content of the accumulator A is being moved to the memory location whose address is in the register pair. Register pair can be B for BC and D for DE. This is also one byte instruction. For example, when we write STXD, then you will find that the content of the accumulator are being moved to the memory that is being pointed by the DE pair. It is also possible that you can exchange the contents of the register pairs, and this can be achieved by making the use of the instruction exchange XCHG, where we can exchange H and L with D and E. So the content of H are exchanged with D, and the content of L are exchanged with E. So the content of the register H and L can be exchanged with the content of the register D and E. So this is also a very useful instruction. Many times while writing the assembly language program, you will find that we need to make the use of such instruction. So thank you, friends, for viewing this session. Hopefully you have understood what we mean by data transfer instructions. And when we actually write the assembly language programs for the microprocessor 8085, there you will find that we will make the use of these instructions. Thank you all for viewing the session.